BlizzCon champions, plus Jamie, ABC here on the Grand Arena. Can Seedus Shaman, can the Wind Walk, or sorry, the Demon Hunter Death Knight composition do it for Mechamorge? Can it keep them alive in the lower bracket? ABC anticipated this melee cleave composition, going with the Frost Mage Elemental Shaman. Let's see what Method Orange can get done here. It's going to be an elimination series.
I think Method Orange locked in this composition, expecting ABC would be running the Rogue Mage Druid. ABC reading it with beautiful mind games. I have to say that they did win this blind pick, but of course Method Orange on this composition, very strong, so not out of it yet. It's gonna be up to Trill to potentially land those mana rifts onto Azeroth. They can get him out of mana. That's when they can start really developing pressure and momentum onto Alec and Jamie.
Trill getting caught in that lightning lasso, and I can only imagine how terrified he is of that spell in particular, having gone down to Zpi's lightning lasso earlier on in the day. Azeroth getting double stun lock comboed into that mana rift, likely the main win condition for Method Orange into the late game. If they can deny Azeroth from drinking, continue this mana rift strategy, they will burn him out and tap ABC out on attrition. But if they get cross crowd control and burst it down during an overextension, or potentially a swap to Mez the Death Knight deeper into dampening, those are going to be the weak points for Method Orange's composition. Can ABC drag it out to that point or burst down Trill prior? Seedus gets polymorphed. Trill not in a position for reverse magic, pinned down, really unable to move, just using the defense of that anti-magic zone to reduce incoming pressure. I-beam immediately interrupted, denying a huge amount of damage. Now another lightning lasso. Huge flurry combo, lots of pressure onto Trill throughout game number one.
Yep, definitely Trill going to be in some trouble. Like we saw in the last series, he was the main pressure point when Method Orange went up against Wildcard Gaming. Method Orange lost that game in literally a matter of seconds. This game is looking a lot better for them. They just need to make sure they don't overreact. So far, they've been trading out defensive cooldowns accordingly. Mez with that anti-magic zone allowed Trill to sort of tank a lot of that incoming damage while Seedus was sitting that polymorph. Another polymorph snuck in there by Alec, stun onto Trill into a lightning lasso. Good setup once again by ABC. And these consistent setups, this consistent damage on Trill has forced him into a very defensive position where he hasn't really found many opportunities to land those precious mana rifts onto Azeroth.
Yeah, he's really been denied as the focus target. If he overextends, he could get caught in a lightning lasso and burst it down. He's not able to maximize his mana rifts, and that could allow ABC to survive to that critical 40% dampening point to where they can switch targets to Mez on that Death Knight and burst him down. So in a way, both teams are on a clock in game number one. Either team could take it. We are tied for the day with North America taking two series and Europe taking two series in the upper bracket. It's going to be EU versus NA, the entire day.
Yep, definitely will be, and we'll have to see who eventually comes up on top. But focusing back up on this matchup, Alec taking a little bit of pressure. Ironbark going to be traded out by Azeroth, but we saw in the cups just how durable both of these compositions are. The Death Knight, Demon Hunter have a lot of self-healing at their disposal. Alec on the Frost Mage can be very slippery as well, had a lot of control on the enemy team, so difficult to take him down early on until healing is reduced by dampening. The main objective right now for Method Orange, if they can survive, is going to be getting Azeroth out of mana before that dampening lands so they can really start developing pressure. But Method Orange on the back foot.
Really curious to see what build Trill is playing, because we don't typically see Demon Hunters under this much pressure. Spirit Link Totem already traded out by Seedus. A huge exchange from Method Orange to just stay alive.
Yep, and Trill ultimately will stay alive, but like you said, that was Trinket, Spirit Link, and Ascendance by Seedus, all of the major defensives that he has to keep Trill up. Trill, of course, still has that Darkness. I'm not sure if he is going to be playing that cover of Darkness, that major Darkness cooldown he normally does, so that should be a good safety net for Method Orange if they need it, but seems like Method Orange, they're realizing they are not winning these trades. They need to sort of regroup, reestablish some of those cooldowns before they're pushing out into the midfield once again. And although Death Knights traditionally are very durable targets, if you're in the open for too long and you have Jamie and Alec just kiting you and teeing off, Mez could be a vulnerability for Method Orange as well.
Very curious to see if ABC can hold out. They've got good mana moving forward, and that's exactly what they need to make it to the 40% dampening mark to take out Method Orange in game number one. And dampening will be a number appearing in the center top part of the screen right below that sword. And as it gets to the number 40%, that is the main win condition for ABC. Whereas the side of Method Orange, their main win condition is that blue bar below Azeroth's giant orange bar. If that goes completely empty, then Method Orange can overwhelm them with pressure. And so far, it's still at a healthy margin, and we're getting closer to dampening. Trill left all alone. Jamie, Lightning Lasso. Huge combo. ABC are going to take it without even needing dampening.
This is unbelievable. I mean, every single time I see or fight a Demon Hunter, they just seem so difficult to kill.
Mana Rifts. Method Orange, they want to win mana strategy. That's why they're implementing the Restoration Shaman. Seedu's not going to have to rely on drinks like the Resto Druid of Azgarath, and that really is the main win condition Method Orange has.
All right, let's see if they can get it done here. This is an elimination series. The loser of this best of five is going home. Will it be North America or Europe going home first? Well, you're going to have to stay tuned to find out. We see Trill leading the charge, jumping right on top of Azgarath. Seedu following up as well. Maybe some purges early on. Method Orange potentially wanting to get a bit cheeky towards ABC on this small battlefield.
Yeah, Mez and Trill now turning their attention over on Alec, trying to get some pressure rolling. Jamie backing him up with a few off heals of his own. Azgarath with the early innervate wants to get that cooldown rolling, throwing out some wild growth, some very expensive heals to keep his team topped off, just to conserve a little bit of mana. If we look at mana, right now it's relatively even, but I expect Azgarath to start losing his mana relatively shortly.
Decent pressure on Alec currently. Jamie with that Lightning Lasso ends up stopping it. Azgarath gets gripped in. There's some mana rifts. This map is definitely way more favored towards Method Orange, and they can burn that mana bar so much more rapidly so long as Trill can stay on target. We do see Trill going after Jamie for a bit, but Jamie running some Pack Spirit Azerite traits and the Ghost Wolf build, so he is unlikely to be the main kill targets. I do imagine that Alec or Azgarath later on in the fight is going to be the main focus point. Alec just tanking Trill here with his Frozen Orb, trying to counter Gress. We should see a bit of a split strategy from Method Orange, and this is very effective against a Restoration Druid if your main objective is to run them out of mana, forcing them to heal two targets and switch their Life Blooms, a highly expensive heal, which that Life Bloom spell is. So this strategy from Method Orange, the split, I actually do like a lot. If they can keep it going without dying is now the next question.
Yeah, I mean, that's going to be very important for them, as they do kind of need the late game. They kind of need dampening, and they need Azgarath to be out of mana if they want to have a hope to take down this team. That's one of the specialties of the Demon Hunter and the Death Knight. They're very durable. They bring consistent damage, but the one weakness of the comp is they don't have that mortal wounds effect like a warrior, a Windwalker monk, an assassination rogue. They can't reduce incoming healing, so they kind of have to wait for dampening to do that for them. That's why we see these games go on for a very long time. Game number one, ABC found a beautiful setup onto Trill. And it's going to be up to Method Orange this game to make sure Seedu, Mez, and Trill, they're all working as a solid unit, not getting divided and conquered like we saw in game number one. Trill has to remain aggressive on Azgarath and keep landing these mana. So far, it's been good. If you look, Azgarath's mana down to around 65%. Seedu now into a full polymorph. Alec looking to get aggressive with his Icy Veins. What's he going to be able to get done?
Gets reversed on his polymorph and totally denied. Well timed there by Trill. Alec is not going to get any value out of that hit. Mez gets Lightning Lasso, but is on diminishing return. Now that threat is out of the way. Method Orange should be feeling confident in this position to deny Azgarath from finding a drink, but Alec is pinning Trill down, trying to stop Seedu from crossing center field, but that Earthbind Totem and the Earth Elemental, although actually activated onto Alec, Hibernate onto Seedu, although overlapped with the Polymorph. They were casting both at the same time. No real choice there. Seedu is locked in crowd control. Mez gets swapped too, and where is this damage coming from? Mez so low on health early on.
Yeah, Mez getting a little bit low. Anti-magic shell and the Icebound Fortitude should deflect. Frozen Orb once again dropped out by Alec. Seedu trying to play catch up right now with that Spirit Walker's Grace. Going to be making him immune to interrupt, so Jamie won't be able to use his Wind Shear. Alec won't be able to use Counterspell. Because of that, Seedu tops off his team. Azgarath once again. Mana Rift lands by Trill on 50% mana. And slowly but surely, Method Orange is developing a lead.
Cyclone secured by Azgarath could be the game-winning play as Mez gets thunderstormed out of the anti-magic zone. Barely connects the Spiritling Totem between the crowd control. Good recovery by Method Orange, but it cost them vital defensive cooldowns to stay alive. Moving forward, Stormkeeper available. If they may look for another swap, I've never seen this amount of pressure. The elemental shamans between both Jamie and Swapsy have been phenomenal in terms of aggression. Usually these matchups take a huge amount of dampening to close out, but throughout, Mez is constantly under fire. Trill as well. Mez is hiding. Seedu's in a polymorph. Lightning Lasso. Where's the mage Alec? Not in line of sight, but securing more crowd control. Comet Storm crashing in. Mez grips Alec, connects a Death Strike. Seedu's out of crowd control. Can support with the Riptides. Azgarath's trying to sneak away and get a drink. Trill uses that metamorphosis to jump on top of him. Azgarath then repositions the ghoulish pet in center field, Frost Nova. They need to make sure that that doesn't stay on Azgarath if they want to find a drink. Method and Orange, even though they've burned some significant defensive cooldowns, still have a lot more left in their arsenal. They've got the mana lead, and so long as they make no blunders, are getting closer and closer to victory on game two.
Every second that goes by, Method Orange is slowly but surely securing their win condition. They just have to hold on, but ABC is not making it easy. A lightning lasso over onto C2. You can see Jamie trying to develop some pressure, but in Ghost Wolf, that spectral recovery is going to be way too powerful for Jamie to really do too much against. That lightning lasso essentially completely wasted, although I do believe Azeroth was able to sneak away a little bit and recover some of his mana, so I think that lightning lasso was more about control rather than a kill attempt. Didn't want CD to be able to stop that drink, and because of that, ABC's back in it.
Trill ducking for cover as Cedu got counterspelled on a heal. Mez peeling, but now he's left behind and bursted down, and dampening's getting higher and higher. Azeroth's mana is looking healthier. ABC have managed to deny that win condition of Method Orange so far if they can keep going a bit longer. Cedu looks like he's trying to sit down for a drink, although his mana not likely to be the main reason that ABC win. Azeroth gets cut down by Trill as they look to swap to him, but he's supported by Jamie. Alec is now overextended. Trill's going to come back to support and force Alec away from Cedu as Alec is constantly harassing him with polymorphs. Alec cannot stay on top of him for long. Ironbark may not even be enough. Blinks back to center field, now likely to recover. Trill and Mez chasing him down in midfield. That could expose Cedu to crowd control. Potentially a hex of Jamie. Needs to be ready for that. Lightning lasso on Trill. This is usually a scary moment, but Earthen Wall Totem of Cedu denies all the damage.
Yeah, and Trill will be able to recover, and Metamorphosis getting a lot of self-healing as well. Good backup by Cedu with that Earthen Wall Totem. Alec now caught into a full stun. Jamie looking to back him up with a full hex onto Cedu. Can they get any damage rolling? Mez and Trill still all over Alec, really denying the pressure that he can put out. Azeroth hasn't been able to sneak away for a drink in quite some time, and because of that, is falling further and further behind on mana. Around 10% dampening. Sid, what dampening do you feel like ABC is going to be able to take down Mez?
It's a magical 40%, unless there's a bit of a miracle prior to that point, but 40% seems to be the magic marker to take down a Death Knight as the Mage Elemental Shaman, and we are now one-fourth, or a little bit over one-fourth of the way there. ABC need to find a drink, though. Their mana's not in good enough position, I believe, to make it to that point, so Method Orange still have an advantage. Innervate gets activated. This could buy Azeroth more time, as all of his healing spells are free while that's activated. Anti-Magic Zone exchanged for the Icy Veins. I think that's a fair trade, but Trill's still low on health. Lightning Lasso. Azeroth stunned up, but this Lightning Lasso isn't going to get a kill. Cedu gets out of crowd control, connects and heals, and Trill begins to stabilize. But Method Orange need to be careful. If they stack up, they could get pinned at the pillar in a frozen orb, and that would be a lot of free damage for Alec. Azeroth, what are you going to do? Your mana's not looking too good. And on hook point, I'm not sure if he's going to be able to find a drink. Alec's getting bursted, but he seems to not care as he jumps into the fight, securing crowd control onto Cedu. Jamie backs him up with some purse towards Trill. They're desperately trying to look for a darkness, but Blur appears to be more than enough for Trill to survive throughout this assault.
Yeah, and keep in mind what is on the line for both of these teams, a $50,000 first place prize pool as well as a ticket to BlizzCon. This is what these guys so far this year have been working towards, and it cannot feel good being in the lower bracket right now, battling for your tournament life. Method Orange getting a little bit low. Mez recovers, good heals, good backup by Cedu. Alec finally getting pressure down just a little bit, and Azeroth's mana down to around 20%. Finally, Method Orange developing a solid lead, but we're at 20% dampening. And if they can last long enough, eventually they might be able to take down Mez and Trill, limiting their self-healing quite a bit at 20% dampening. If we get up to 30, 40%, that's when ABC is really going to have a great opportunity.
One ice block out of the way, and we are now halfway to that 40% dampening mark. It's getting down to the wire here between reigning BlizzCon champions Method Orange and former BlizzCon champions ABC in elimination series of best of five. Loser of this is going to be going home in last place, not where you want to be as the reigning champions. The morale is low for both teams, but they're desperately trying to cling to victory here in the lower bracket. Cedar's crowd control, Trill and Mez both in trouble. Dampening continues to mount, but at the same time, Azeroth has not been able to find any opportunities to drink. Cedar with the Earth Elemental chasing Azeroth. That is keeping him in combat, denying him from drinking for a substantial amount of time. Good awareness on Cedar's part. That's all about denying drinks. It's all about mana rifting and then bursting down the mage. If Method Orange can keep it together a bit longer, they've got it. They've got this in the bag.
Yeah, things are not looking good for them at this point. Azeroth getting a little bit low. Lightning lasso on Mez, though. Can they take him down if Jamie has a big Earth Shock? We've seen those from him before. The lightning lasso into a huge Earth Shock crit. Cedu gets interrupted, but Mez with the anti-magic shell should be able to recover. Trill and Mez still all over Alec. He hasn't been able to get out too much damage. If you look, He's been holding on to his cold snap, so it's unlikely he's going to have a third ice block available unless he can last another 3 minutes, but I think that's just really unlikely.
What?
Mez getting burst to down lower. Anti-magic zone gets traded out. Spearling totem as well. Method Orange is running on fumes in terms of defensive cooldowns.
Oh, nice coordination. Jamie and Alec both casting crowd control, and that gets Seedu's Gladiator's Medallion. Now Hexed on it. That's the Icebound Fortitude and the Spearling totem. Suddenly, there's a massive cooldown lead for ABC, but there's a significant mana lead for Method Orange, and it's still anyone's match. We're now 3/4 of the way of making it to that magic marker, and Mez will have basically no defense to survive at that moment in time. But Azgrath has no mana. He goes for the Innervate play. Trill strips it off. Azgrath is getting no free healing. He's got a Demon Hunter chasing him down. He's on hook point. The smallest map. Where is he going to go? Basically nowhere. Seedu's on top of him. You are not drinking, Azgrath. You have to play the rest of this game with absolutely zero mana left. ABC, they've got one more ice block in the tank, but Alex interrupted. Cold snap, ice block. Alex stays alive, but there's no mana. Seedu looks for a hex onto Jamie. Azgrath doesn't even have mana to dispel it.
Uh-oh.
Now he's stunned up. Another mana rift. Alex out of the ice block. All three members of Method Orange are looking to close out in game number two. Lava Bursts are flying in. Iron Bark is the final defense for ABC to make a stand, but it doesn't appear to be enough. It needs to be enough. Can they somehow pull it off? Seedu's in a hex. Mez is exposed. 5% of that 40% dampening mark. Huge hits are coming in. Lightning Lasso comboed. They managed to break it up. The darkness protecting Mez, but he gets thunderstormed out of its safety. Alec and Mez both in so much trouble.
Yeah, Mez in a lot of trouble. Alec does manage to kite away. Mez finally running back to the pillar, getting some death strikes onto Jamie as Trill's in hot pursuit, keeping Azgrath completely topped out of mana. It's unlikely either of these teams go to full HP once again.
Polymorph!
Full polymorph secured by Alec. Beautiful plays. Gets reversed by Trill, but Mez still just taking so much damage. Earthenwall totem!
Oh!
Unfortunately, gets rooted outside. Method Orange fall in game number two.
Are now on match point and looking like potentially a 6-0 for the day here in the spring finals. They'll be the first team sent home. North America, it's not looking good. Can they manage to crawl back in this as Seedu plants new seeds on his Restoration Druid? Seedu stunned up. Where's the crowd control? No follow-up. Jamie, though, taking some heat. Able to duck for cover. Once again, we've seen Trill just explode against these elemental shamans, and it could still be the case, and maybe they're shaky moving into what could be their final game of the tournament.
Yeah, we'll have to see what Method Orange can get done. This is their compositional advantage as well as their map pick. Already burning through hook point. Unfortunately, a really close loss for them in that last game. ABC managing to find the kill on Mez eventually at that 30-40% dampening mark in the game. Now, Seedu getting caught into the Lightning Lasso. ABC trying to find some pressure, but so far, Method Orange, it's been looking a lot better for them. Everyone's topped off. You can really see the sort of the differences in the healing that the Restoration Druid and the Restoration Shaman have available.
All right, let's see what they can get done here on Talaran Sewers. If they can nail these mana rifts, keep up their pressure, and ultimately close this out. Method Orange need to win 3 in a row against ABC, top caliber team, and they don't only have to rely on this Elemental Shaman Mage. They have more than this in their back pocket should they need it. Alec gets bursted down, but Ironbark appears to be enough. Seedu has been swapped too quite frequently by ABC. Maybe they smell some weakness on that Restoration Druid. They've been kind of feeling it out and trying to find a kill there, and I'm curious to see if they manage to do so. Method Orange cannot afford any mistakes. This is their final last opportunity to stay in the tournament.
Yeah, there's been good pressure on Jamie so far. It looks like he's going to be using that Fire Blood Racial to remove the Gladiator's Maledict Trinket that Method Orange did use, keeping himself alive. Now a little bit vulnerable, could get caught into a full stun, but this is another one of those matchups where I feel like outside of a big Elemental Shaman one-shot or a blunder from ABC, the game will end up going to dampening and mana will play such a huge role. You can see Azgrath already establishing a massive lead, sitting down for a drink, but Seedu's been doing a good job making sure he can keep his mana afloat, as I think that's going to be such an important factor in this particular match.
Yeah, Azgrath, though, I would have expected to be a little bit lower on mana at this point with the Mana Rift strategy. Trill is running and basically pioneered. Seedu bashed up once again. ABC is just hammering down on Seedu to try and kill him, so there's going to be a lot of pressure put on his shoulders, but there's almost always a lot of pressure put onto Seedu's shoulders, and I do believe that he's going to be able to handle it. Can they keep it going? Trill gets bursted by another Lightning Lasso. It is the scariest moment in the match for the side of Method Orange, but they make it out alive for now.
Yeah, good consistent wind shears coming in from Jamie as well, denying some of the I-beam damage that Trill has. That's nice to see. Sometimes people don't realize you can interrupt the Demon Hunter and you can actually prevent a lot of his incoming damage, a lot of his incoming healing as well. So Jamie consistently landing those You can tell it's high-level Elemental Shaman gameplay and allows him to have a slight edge in this matchup, denying some of that damage and healing troll really has. If you look at mana, once again, relatively even for both teams. It looks like Method Orange, they're trying to get momentum rolling onto Jamie, but Jamie's just been doing a really good job kiting, and the problem is, when you go after Jamie too long, Alec is able to just spam out Frostbolts, really amplifying his damage, as well as consistently get out Polymorphs when he needs them.
All right, CD's mana's looking good here. Game number three for Method Orange. No mistakes can be made. Mana rifts just keep coming from Trill over onto Azkarath. They actually get Iron Bark and Bark Skin leads establishing itself. Finally, solid, consistent strategy, but anti-magic zone, Trill jumps out of it, manages to get back inside of its protection for now, but Cedu's in a polymorph. Do manage to deny the lightning lasso, that could have been scary. Cedu is still crowd controlled. If they can manage to get a cyclone, Trill is looking to deny it, but may not be able to. Finally, Trill does manage to deny it. Somehow hold on. Big heal from Cedu. Trill stays alive, constantly on a razor's edge here. Match point for ABC still.
Yeah, but you can see Method Orange, they're starting to develop that lead in mana like we kind of thought that they would. They did in game number two as well, but ABC, they managed to hold on. Azeroth still doing a really good job trying to kite away using the Innervate, topping off his team, now getting in cat form, potentially trying to get out of combat, trying to look for a drink. You can see Alec in a good position to deny Trill, and Mez are being able to reconnect. Mez and Trill, they're just kind of going for it, committing a Maledict. Once again, Fireblood gets used. Jamie kites away, Lightning Lasso. I think Azeroth is going to be going to completely full mana. Big reset. That was very nicely set up by ABC.
All right, ABC looking to send home the reigning BlizzCon champions. They just need one more win here on Dalaran Sewers. CD doing everything in his power. He was reluctant to switch over to this Druid. It seemed to be a little bit of a lack of confidence, but I feel like his Druid has been solid throughout the day. They've just been close to victory constantly with it, but now with two games out of the way on his Shaman and lost, maybe it's too little too late. Can CD manage to do it, or ABC just going to have the chokehold 3-0 in the lower bracket and send them home? Trill once again charging over, but Azeroth has managed to maintain his mana at a healthy margin. With dampening just starting, it's still anyone's game.
Yeah, Azeroth moving in, looking to deny a heal from Cedu. Looks like ABC, they have a lot of momentum at this point. Jamie caught into a Chaos Nova. Mez and Trill finally finding some damage, but caught into a Nova. Alec now moving forward. A nice double cast there by Alec and Azeroth. When Cedu is a Druid, basically what can happen is Alec can cast a Polymorph. Azeroth at the same time can cast a Hibernate, and that way Cedu really, there's no good move, essentially. If he's in travel form, then he gets hibernated. If he's in human form, then he gets caught into a polymorph. So beautiful Mage Druid synergy from ABC and forces CD into a little bit of crowd control. Unfortunately, wasn't able to really get much off the back of that, but a little bit later on in the game, that play could really pay off.
All right, dampening continues to mount. Once again, that magic 40% marker for these Elemental Shamans, Mez will be a liability at that point. And Azeroth doing a solid job maintaining his mana throughout this onslaught. Trill Shadow Melds and incoming Glyre's Maledict, avoiding that healing absorption. Good awareness, top level play, keeping it together despite such a long day and low morale. Still not able to make any mistakes, so they'll be sent home. It's match point. Alec charges over, looking for a polymorph. Cedu cannot afford to blunder and be polymorphed without any other sort of follow-up. He manages to avoid it at the pillar. They're stabilizing. Azeroth is trying to sneak away and drink, but with that ghoul of Mez chasing him down, unable to find that opportunity. Dampening now at 10%. Azeroth still trying to sneak away. Cedu sees him. He's trying to jump over, but gets flurried and snared, unable to make it across. Azeroth finally getting stunned up by Trill for another Mana Rift combo. Elemental chasing down Cedu. He's not going to be able to find any drinks. Azeroth trying to retreat away with a well-timed wild charge. Mez left downstairs. Cedu gets caught in a stun. Jamie swaps some pressure over to him and bursts him. They've been feeling Cedu throughout this fight, and it could be an opening for them to kill him later on if he's not careful, or even make him panic and overcommit cooldowns. 13% dampening, and it continues to rise. Again, looking for that to get to 40%. See if Method Orange can close this out. Half mana remaining. Perfectly timed stunned here by Trill, denying the Innervate. They managed to strip that off, and now Cedu overextends. No Bark Skin. A bit of a disrespect. Anti-magic zone needs to be enough. They dispel it, but he gets knocked out. Big hit here by Alec. Cedu in trouble. Could be a darkness as well. This is devastation for Method Orange as they're on match point. Lightning Lasso gets trinketed. Iron Bark is committed. That thunderstorm from Jamie was almost lethal, and he's still on the hunt.
Yeah, these European elemental shamans doing work in this tournament here today. Seedu still conduit is done. No Barskin, no nothing. Darkness gets dropped out. The last line of defense for Method Orange. Seedu has to hold on. He has to try to recover, but Alec and Jamie, they're just all over him. Seedu leaps away. Can he survive? Barskin gets traded out, as well as the safety of that waterfall in the nick of time for Method Orange in order to survive. 20% dampening. Method Orange stabilizes. Now they need to start getting some pressure.
All right. Mana totally tapped. Still 20% left in that dampening tank, but Seedu is just constantly getting blasted by ABC. He did get into bear form right before that stun, soaking up some huge hits. He may just be dead if he didn't pull that off. He's still low on health. Jamie is just tearing him to pieces. Huge damage, and Seedu is going to get chomped by Azeroth. ABC.
Feed versus the fake Zebras. We're all tied up. 1-1. Who is going to find themselves on match point? Who is going to get a little bit further into this tournament? Keep in mind, folks, we're doing a brand new thing. You have just entered, in the middle of history, the longest series that has ever been played in Battle for Azeroth.